So Tim Ned, man, what's going on? How you feeling?
What's good, bro?
I'm good.
Good to be here, man. Appreciate you, man.
Yeah, appreciate you coming out today.
Yeah, no doubt.
So just to get started, tell me about yourself. Where are you from exactly?
Okay, I was born in Fort Worth. We stayed there to about just like a couple months. Then we moved to Athens, Greece. My dad, he was in the military, so like I was a military brat, so I've been pretty much
moving around the world.
But represented Houston all the way. Been out here, man, for over 15 years plus. So yeah, I'm a Houstonian for sure.
So about Houston, what's your favorite part about Houston?
My favorite part, man, it's just the people. Yeah, just the people in general, man.
So do you like Houston better, or I mean, as far as the other places that you stayed? What city do you like the most?
Houston, man.
Houston.
Love my city, bro. Yeah, for sure.
So, what exactly got you into producing music?
Producing music, man. It was out of curiosity, man. I was one of those kids, like, you know, like, Saturday morning, like, when you clean it up around the house, whatever.
Yeah.
I would always, like, stick by the radio. And I was always, like, just thinking, like, how did they actually make this music? So, like, I just did it out of curiosity, so... You know, it was a Christmas time, and my mom, she asked me what I want for Christmas. And we was at Radio Shack. I'm kind of like telling my age right now. But we was at Radio Shack, I saw this keyboard. It had like all these different sounds and all these different samples. And I was like sitting there playing with it. And I was like, man, this is how they do it.
Yeah.
So I was like, man, I want this. Like, you ain't got to wrap it up, nothing. Just, we take it home right now. And ever since then, I've just been like mimicking, you know, each song I hear on the radio, like a song my dad would play, I'll just like go back in my room, like I was like just mimic it. So that's how I started, just curious.
So, cause you say that you went to Radio Shack, you know, Radio Shack not even open no more. how long have you been producing, or at least taking it serious?
Man, it's been since I was a senior in high school. So it's 15 years plus, bro. I've been doing it for a minute, yeah.
So speaking of high school, what high school did you go to?
Dulles High School, Sugar Land.
All 4 years?
Yeah, all 4 years. Yeah.
Okay, so as far as Dulles High School, and you was producing, did your classmates know that you was producing in high school?
Well, the thing, I mean, yeah, towards like the, probably like my sophomore year, man, it was like, my mom probably get upset about this, but man, it was like so many dudes in my house, bro.
Yeah.
Like, we was like just freestyling, had the microphone hanging from the ceiling fan on that vibe. So like, it was like on some, I don't know if you're familiar with Hustle and Flow, like how they did like, hey, you know, cut the fans. It was like on that level, you know what I'm saying?
Gotcha,
so like, that's how we, you know, generally started. And too, like, I was that kid, like, I was the dude that beat on the table. I was that dude too, so yeah.
So what softwares do you use when you produce beats?
Man, Logic Pro, Pro Tools. But I'm like a Logic dude, so.
You like that over Pro Tools?
Yeah, for sure.
And why is that?
It's just like an easier, I guess, process. Cause like, man, the way I work real fast.
Yeah.
So like I can make the track in Logic and record at the same time.
Okay.
And then as I'm recording, I can like add instruments as well too. It's just like a faster process.
Gotcha. Yeah. And speaking of the faster process, how long does it take you to produce a beat?
Man, it just depends on the vibe too, man. It's like, I say less than 5 minutes probably. Yeah, probably so.
Oh, so you pretty quick with it, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Do you lean towards gangsta rap, or do you lean towards the vibe rap?
It don't matter, man. Good music is good music, bro. Like, you know, if it's, you know, gangsta, if it's like on some, like, kid bop, whatever. Like, I mean, I'm willing to do it. McDonald's, hey, look, it don't even matter to me, you know. Like, if it got a vibe, if it's jamming, I'm all with it. Yeah.
So, as far as producing, I see that you have like credits from Nipsey, Lil Kiki, Fat Pimp, and others. Can you talk about that exactly? What songs did you produce?
For Nipsey, it was off the Marathon mixtape, the very first one. It was called Grind Mode. I produced the record, and I actually featured on the record as well. Lil Kiki, I just landed a single, his second single from his new project, Self-Made 3, Live By. I got another record on there, actually featured on there as well too, called Autopilot. Me and Kiki, like, we have a history. Like, I did a couple records from him, like, back in the day as well too. But this is my first initial single that, you know, he actually did a video for, and he's actually pushing it. We got some more records as well too. Fat Pimp, Fat Pimp actually, he was the first person to put me on his tour. So like, that was like, he was like, kind of like just broke the ice on that.
Like, a lot of pictures with him, like y'all like real close.
So the thing with that, me and him got a project together.
Okay,
we got a project together. So it's called the Art of Ratchet. Derek McKinney, the CEO of Loud Music, he kind of like puts it like if Kanye West and 2 Chainz did an album together, that's what it kind of like would sound like.
So, as far as the Nipsey track, how did that come about?
So shout out to my boy Dutch. He's a, I guess like a high school friend. He was actually, I don't know if he's a manager or like he was involved with the whole Nipsey, I guess, process in the beginning. He had hit my manager up, K Rich. He was like, "Hey, we got Nipsey coming to SF2. SF2 is like a little pop up shop, like an urban spot. Like, you know, they can get a different type of like T-shirts and stuff like that." And he had a pop up shop up there, and like he wasn't as big as, well, I would say like in Houston, he wasn't as big worldwide then, but he was like, "Man, come up here and, you know, if you got some beats, you can submit it to him." I was like, "Cool." So we went up there, just, you know, on a limb. Had a CD. That's how long ago it was. It was a beat, beats like just on CD. And I told him, I was like, "You know, you can have whatever is on this on the CD." Cool. We got exchanged emails. Within I think it was like maybe 2 weeks. He emailed me saying that he's gonna be sending me something from the CD. Let's do it. That following week, emailed me the track. It was the one that I was on the hook as well too. He's like, "Man, I think you got something. Like, you got a nice sound. Do you mind if I use the track?"
Goddamn right. You weren't tripping. You were playing. Yeah,
that's what I gave the CD for. And yeah, so like that's how I landed, man. Yeah, when opportunity, you know, when it presents itself, you gotta take it, bro.
Yeah, most definitely.
Back on that Kanye West 2 Chainz too. Mm-hmm. You feel like you like the Kanye West of Houston?
I would say I'm the Tim Daddy Houston. I'm not gonna put myself with nobody else. Shout out to Kanye. He's great what he does. I followed, you know, some of his footsteps as well too. But I'm more, you know, myself, Tim Daddy.
Say that who got you into the music?
Man, Dr. Dre really like the Chronic album changed my life, bro.
You see the LA hat.
Yeah, man. I live in California as well too, live in Sacramento, so yeah, shout out to California. I got people in like Long Beach, Oakland too. So shout out to LA. Dr. Dre was probably like the first person that like just really changed my life, man.
As far as Lil Kiki, you know, he's a Houston legend also. So what's our relationship exactly?
Man, Kiki is a cool dude, man. He kind of like took me in as well too. You know, like we had like real conversations as well too. It's not like, you know, "Hey, send me some beats." Okay, cool. Like we really have like conversations within, you know, within the weeks. Like he'll hit me up, I hit him up just off a random, just to check in. Check, you know what I'm saying? So like it's a real relationship. It's not nothing like, you know, I just give him beats and that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So picking back up off of the tour, your first time on tour, can you detail that experience?
Man, it was a Texas tour. It was we did a bunch of cities in Texas. It was pretty dope, man. You know, Fat Pimp is a legend to me. You know, like everybody knows him. So yeah, for sure. Like, and to actually see him perform as well too, incredible, man. Yeah. Man, packed house every night, and it just gave me the opportunity to, I guess, like present my music to people that don't even know me. You know what I'm saying? At the same time, and just get that, get my feet wet. As well too, so it was a dope experience, man. I loved every minute of it too. Yeah,
that's what's up for sure. Yeah. So talking about your song, "Cool, Casual, Sexy."
Yeah.
Did you produce that beat or was that somebody else? You produced it yourself?
Yeah, I produced it. Yeah.
Okay.
And the track is old too, man. And the story, I gotta share the story. So the actual beat, right? I was about to throw away.
Wow.
Yeah, I mean, at the time, like I wasn't really like feeling the track itself. And my manager's like, "Man, don't throw it away, bro. Like, don't throw it away." Like, they kept on stressing because I was real bad, like, to do that. Like, I make a beat, like, I don't like it, and I delete it. So, but this time, they was like, "Man, no. Like, don't delete it. Like keep it." So, I sat on it, and I had a session with I'm not going to say her name, but I had a session with this female artist, and I was about to give her the record. But then, after the session, we was like, "Nah, it don't fit with her. I think you should keep it." All right, cool. So like we sat on it again for like maybe like another year or two. And my DJ, shout out to DJ Stayso, we was at his crib, bro. Like we had the track, we had the idea of Cool Captain Sexy. Like that was the whole concept of the record. We sat down and wrote that song within an hour. Like we went by the liquor store, got some E&J Apple. Yeah, we did. Like we was on a budget, straight up. We just drank the whole bottle, finished the record within about an hour. And we was like, this is the one. Yeah. So shout out to E&J Apple.
Definitely. Yeah. So how long does it take you to record one song casually? Just
it depends, man. It depends. It's a process for me. It's like if you get like a puzzle, if you like work out a puzzle, right? You just throw a puzzle out and you just kind of figure out like where it's at. So like I do it bit by bit. I may do the outside work. Let's say like a puzzle. I might do the outside work and work my way in. And sometimes it's like it's just like an instant vibe. It's like I may finish the whole song that right then and there. And at the same time, like the way my mind works, I can hear the song in my head, like the whole song. So like generally I have to slow my mind down so I can hear each element of the record. So at the end of the day, it's not like, you know, a set, you know,
it's
not a set time frame.
That was always my question for producers. Yeah. Like, do y'all know who y'all want on the song already when y'all making the beat? Y'all already know who y'all want?
Sometimes I get a surprise where my beats land sometimes. Like, you know, I was like, man, I didn't expect this person to really, you know, I guess elevate this record. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah. So like it's always a magical moment, man, to me, you know? Yeah.
So have you ever had any crazy experiences while filming a music video?
A music video?
Yeah. Or just being at a video shoot in general. Have you ever seen anything crazy happen? In the industry?
Studio sessions, yeah.
Studio, okay, so can you detail?
I remember this studio session where it was I was working in a studio in Sunnyside. And the dude that he owned the studio, he was like, hey, I'm about to dip out right quick, so I need you to hold it down. I was like, all right, cool. But the thing is, when he meant hold it down, he gave me a shotgun. So I'm like, he teaching me how to, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, how to, hey, so what you do, you gotta load it like this, just in case somebody's like, you know, I'm like, all right, cool.
Yeah.
I was in the
kind of caught you on guard.
Yeah, with a shotgun.
So, who has been your favorite person to collab with so far? And that could be music, from you doing music with somebody else, or just producing.
Oh man, that's tough. I say the dopest experience is the current right now, like with Fat Pim, like we doing this project together. It's like it's magical, man. Like I may like have an idea, send it to him, and he sends me something like totally different back. I'm like, damn, I didn't expect him to do that. It's like, wow, that's pretty dope.
We get that vibe from the pictures. Like it's like I said, you can just tell like y'all real close.
For sure, bro. Yeah, that's been fam since day one, man. Like he really, you know, embraced me in like. School me to the game, so like, yeah, shout out to Fat Pimp for real.
So, you have a few collabs in the city. That's what I meant there. I apologize. So, what artists from the city do you want to collab with that you haven't collabed with?
I want to collab with everybody, to be honest with you, bro. Man, Killer Calion, we've been going back and forth on text. I really want to get him like in the studio for real. Man, it's a lot, man. Meg Thee Stallion, I wouldn't mind seeing her too. Like for
He's
real.
He's taking over right now.
Yeah, and I got some records for you. If she listening, I got some records for you too. everybody, man. It don't even have to be like a well known, you know, artist. It could be somebody that's just starting off. So like,
if you dope,
you
dope.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, for sure. So. Yeah.
So what has been the best advice that you've been given in life?
To believe in yourself, man, no doubt. That's the ultimate key to me. That I guess to me, like that sets like the foundation of of your success. You have to believe in yourself at the end of the day, because like if you don't, then ain't nobody gonna believe in you, man. So yeah,
definitely. So as far as support, do you feel like the city has been supporting you? I mean, you got a nice following on Instagram. I mean, and you got these collabs. I mean, you pretty known in the city.
I mean, like, I think they do. I'm not going to be like, no, you used to know Show Me the Support. I mean, I think they do. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I just got to make more records, man. Just, you like, you know, just solidify myself even more. So, yeah, I'm not hating on the city at all. Like, they show love everywhere I go, so.
So, because, like you said, they're showing love to you.
Yeah.
But on the other side, do you think Houston supports all artists in general?
I think so.
A lot of people always say, like, Houston don't support. Yeah.
But the thing is, like, I believe so. Could it be better? I think it could be better.
Yeah.
I think once we get to that point where it can be better, man, we can really, like, take over the game, like, for real. Like,
Atlanta vibe.
Yeah, it's like, I don't want to compare it to Atlanta. I mean, like, I know a lot of people do.
Yeah.
Cause you know Atlanta's kind of like, I mean, they running the game. I ain't gonna lie.
Yeah.
But I still think Houston can do that though. You know what I'm saying? Like we definitely can do that. Like it's a lot of talent in Houston, bro. Like the underground.
Definitely.
Like who's running the game right now? Like Beyonce, Meg. Come on, bro. Like they from Houston. You know what I'm saying? So like,
for sure.
Like we got it, man. We just Travis Scott. You know what I'm saying? So it's like we got it.
So, because you mentioned earlier in the interview that you actually lived in L.A. So
I lived in Sacramento.
Oh, Sacramento.
Yeah.
Okay, so compare that, Sacramento to the Houston.
Yeah.
As far as support and rap, and I guess the industry.
I mean, I was a kid when I was in Cali, so.
So you wasn't really rapping or?
No, I was still being, I was still doing kid stuff, bro.
You grew up in Cali and moved here later in life?
I moved out here in 96, 97. Around that time, that's when I got introduced to Screw as well too.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was a big difference from West Coast and out here. So
in the South,
you grew up with NWA, you grew up with SUC.
Yeah, man, like when it was at its prime too. Yeah. Like I came in like I guess right on time, you know.
So I really lost track in my mind. Okay, so how do you feel about artists moving out of their cities? Because a lot of people do say that they feel like they should move to Atlanta or move to LA to pursue their careers.
I think that's an individual choice that person has to make. I do encourage artists from here to, you know, get outside they stay in their cities for sure. To me, it's like that's a whole different vibe. Especially like if you go to LA and you try to record out there, man, they on point. I remember going to the studio. And it's like a building, like each room is a different studio, bro. Like you get a different vibe in each room. So like something like that, just to, I guess, like get out your comfort zone is always a good thing. In every state, like, man, like, you know, Georgia, Atlanta, you can go to New York, catch a vibe, you know. So I encourage artists, I mean, like if you want to move, that's totally up to you. But I do encourage artists to move around.
So what's your take on artists that actually blow up and they might get signed, but they decide to stay in their city and don't move? Let me rephrase it. Mm-hmm. Staying in their city and they know they got hate. For example, like Nipsey and Mo3, you know, you got these different situations. King Von, he wasn't staying in Atlanta, but he still got these rappers that's in these bad situations.
Yeah.
So do you think rappers should move out of their city?
It just depends on the situation, you know. I just think it depends on the situation. Yeah, it's like in a bad environment. Why would you stay in a bad environment?
Sunnyside situation is like, do you think you should be in that, like?
Man, we never went back to the studio, bro. I think that was the last
session. You just gave it up.
Yeah, I'm not finna risk. I mean, nah, I'm not finna do all that. I gotta worry about recording, then worry about somebody breaking it. Nah, I ain't finna do all that, bro. I ain't signed for that, nah, for sure, nah. So, yeah, if you're in a bad environment, I move quick.
So just to piggyback up off of just your personal life, do you have kids?
Yeah, I do.
How many?
I have three.
Three kids?
Yeah, and 3-year-old, 8-year-old, and 13.
Okay, and they all by the same mother?
Yeah, same mom. Bro.
Okay.
And the BMs.
You don't want that?
I think my mama raised me right, man. I think my parents raised me right. Not saying that that's bad or nothing, but hey, I don't want none of that.
So, what's one message that you like to give to your supporters? Something that you want them to know?
About myself or just?
Just in general. Just, man, about the people that do support you.
Man, I think it just goes back to the advice. man, believe in yourself. Whatever you want to do, you can do it. But it just starts with you, you know, from the beginning. That's the general foundation of it, to be successful.
Definitely. Yeah. So what's next for you exactly? As far as projects, visuals coming out, you got a project with Fat Pimp?
Yeah, me and Fat Pimp got a project coming out, the Art of Ratchet. Make sure y'all look for that. We got some crazy features on there too. Like, you're gonna be surprised on the features.
Do you have a date for it?
We don't have a date for it, not yet. We do have a listening party. I'll let y'all definitely let y'all know about that.
I appreciate that.
It's gonna be a dope event too, man. Yeah, y'all gonna be like, okay, yeah,
we're definitely tapping.
A few other productions. I was in the studio with Dope Beezy last night. Working with a couple of the artists on the label, Live Music, Cody Blake, Skyra, Chelsea. Just doing a lot of productions for the city. Working on my project as well too. Not really in a rush for it. I'm doing so much other production with other artists. But yeah, man, you're gonna see a lot of me in 2021 for sure. I think we got a scheduled date. I think it's later on. I think it's in August where we're going to Sweden. We're gonna do a little tour out there. So
you're actually going on tour. Is it just you, or you going with?
Yeah, it's just me.
Oh, okay. And it's all financed by you also.
Well, the label, Live Music.
Oh, label. Yeah, okay, got you.
For sure.
All right, well, we appreciate you for coming out, and we're going to definitely tap back in with you.
For sure, man. Appreciate y'all, man.
Definitely.